Amateur Fantasy for me.
For you, it was almost bordering on.
Yeah, almost bordering on.
For me, it was a little bit more serious.
I'm literally giddy like a kid. This is the kind of things you dream about when you're a child. Even had the chance to tell Fiona this because actually most of our hours spent together have been singing, but I went to Australia for the first time with my own band back in, I think it was 1996, and we were doing an in-store, and you know, at the end of the in-store, the record store, as a sort of plus for being there for hours on end. See, you can pick up any CDs you want. And we all trailed around this record store, and I found Tidal, and I just liked the way, I knew nothing about the artist. And I picked up this CD and I was like, yeah, I'll take this. I don't know anything about it, but I'll take it. And then I had a CD Discman, because it was that long ago. And I listened to it every single night in my bunk for the entire duration of my tour. And I fell madly in love with this extraordinary talent and this godlike, like angelic voice. I know that people wax on lyrical, but if you look back at any of my press over the last billion years that I've been alive, I've always name-checked Fiona. And so for her to come tonight and share in this extraordinary event with these amazing musicians, she likes to bite me, I don't know why. So, Fiona, I'm going to let Fiona's voice do the talking.